Hey everyone, it's Daniel.
And Matthew.
And Mikey.
And we are
A to Z Thrills.
And today we are here at Universal's Island of Adventure for this, right behind us, Grinchmas. We're actually here today for the Grinch breakfast, and we'll be here later on tonight for the actual first night of the holiday tour.
Well, the holiday tour is at Studios.
Yeah.
Well, it's everywhere.
Yeah, it's everywhere.
We're going to see the Grinch, everywhere. We're going to see Max, we're going to eat lots of food, we're going to get fat, happy, and sassy.
So come along for the adventure.
Perfect, let's do it. So the Grinch breakfast takes place inside a Circus McGurk's Cafe, and they're going to have different options for us to try. So let's go in and have some Grinch-themed food. So I do want to say that this year is a little bit different from the years past that we've actually came here. So instead of actually meeting the Grinch inside Circus McGurk's over here where he used to be, we're actually going to be meeting him before we even eat. Last year and the year before that, we always met him after we ate. So it is a little bit different, but not too much of a difference
Well, to be fair, last year was a lot different because Circus McGurk's Cafe Stupendous was under refurbishment. So they moved all the experiences to Confisco Grill, which it was a lot nicer, to be honest, but it wasn't on brand. So they could not continue with that.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll get off.
But
I just had to throw that
from
in there.
Everything that we've seen, the first day had a lot of problems. Like, it was hours to meet the Grinch. Thankfully, it has been fixed, and we're only going to wait probably like 15, maybe 20 minutes at most to meet the Grinch. And from what the waitress had said is that we're going to place our orders, then we're going to go meet the Grinch, and by the time we get back, our food should be here. So let's go ahead and look at the actual menu. We have everything from the Grinch breakfast. We have green eggs and ham, Martha May's chicken and waffles, which I'm pretty sure Matt is going to be getting.
Probably.
We have Cindy Lou Who's Belgian waffles, avocado toast, and chai pudding. No, thank you. For our little Who's, we also have the green Grinch pancake, the berry Belgian waffle, a green pizza. That's interesting.
It's eggs.
Ah, and fluffy scrambled eggs, and then beverages we have, of course, juice, coffee, soft drinks, and the special Grinch sour apple.
Sour green apple, icy whipped sweet cream topping, and red sugar crystals.
Ooh.
That sounds like it's right up my alley.
Perfect. Okay, drinks have been placed. We are now in line to meet the Grinch. And one thing that is new for this year is that anytime you can also meet Sam I Am. I don't remember him being ever out for the past few years, so if it is something new for this year, that is amazing. Also, one thing that our server did tell us is that apparently some days, including today, if you don't have a reservation, you can actually come up and pay later. So therefore, you don't have to worry about getting a reservation early and hoping that there's a day that you want. You can actually just come on up, come on in, meet the Grinch and everything. But remember, you will be paying later and it will be the full price. So take that with a grain of salt. But let's go ahead, wait in line, and meet the Grinch.
Hello!
If it isn't the Grinch.
That's me. I like the green.
So,
what's going on? What's up?
Well, we wanted to ask, what's your favorite dessert here or food? Is it the roast beast or is it like cupcakes?
I think you know the answer.
What else could it possibly be but the onion?
Yeah, touche. Touche.
Why do you think I put onions on every single platter?
Now, do you hide the onions from the other hoos so therefore they don't taste the onion?
What do you think this is for?
Oh, gotcha.
There's a system for everything. Cheese. I like onions a lot more.
I'm lactose intolerant, so.
There we go, me too.
Gotta have it.
Well, I might not be lactose intolerant. All I know is onions are better than cheese.
That is true. Well, thank you so much, Grinch, and hopefully we'll see you again later.
Well, actually, we will see you later tonight, and Max.
Yes.
We're going to go on the holiday tour.
Excellent. Right. See you later. Thank you for coming to visit. Thank you for letting me talk about onions, my favorite subject.
Of course. That did not take long at all. Literally, we went in line maybe 15-20 minutes, and when we got back, look what we found. We have the drinks. We have some muffins, we have some granola, and some fresh fruit, which of course I am not going to eat because I don't like fruit, but from what Matt's reaction is, how is this? How is it good?
Grinch sour apple is very good.
Oh, it like weighs nothing. Like it's just like air. That's not bad.
No, it's good.
It's just it's a sour green apple, icy with whipped cream on top. So it's sugar with sugar with more sugar on top. So it'll keep us going.
Perfect. Oh, yeah.
So we started with this like little kind of, I'm gonna call it appetizers. Came with some yogurt, granola with some honey on top. Personally, this was my favorite thing. Even though the yogurt, plain yogurt, the honey and granola make it pretty good. I'm just a sucker for a yogurt in the morning, like whether it's, you know, with fruit or granola. So like for me, this is good. The muffins, I had a bite of one of the cinnamon muffins. It wasn't bad. It's a little hard, but it's warm. Like mine at least was very warm, even after coming back from meeting the Grinch. So, and then the little bowl of fruit that's here, it's your basic raspberries, blackberries, some blueberries, grapes, blueberries. It's fruit. You can't really go wrong.
It's fruit.
It's fresh, very fresh. But other than that, I mean, so far so good.
We ordered all of our food yet?
Yes.
Yeah.
You have, what did you end up getting?
I got the Grinch pancakes.
The Grinch pancakes. Good choice. You?
Martha May's chicken and waffles.
Also fantastic choice. And you?
Chicken and waffles.
Wonderful. Now, do you plan to let them try your Grinch pancakes?
Of course.
Wonderful. You would be surprised at the amount of people who do not feel that sentiment.
Sharing is caring.
Yeah.
Wonderful. That is actually philosophy that we really use here in Whoville. And I know a lot about philosophy. I have a PhD.
Oh, really?
And
Yes.
You might say that this is all because of me.
Really? Is there some backstory there?
Backstory?
Yes.
Well, I do actually have my own interior design firm.
Really?
Yes, the Decora.
Ooh.
Yes, so, my Dora Decora. Dora Decora. No, it's Decora. Okay.
Perfect.
Yes. So I've never been wrong. So whenever she has said, well, I'm not sure about that red bulb, I've said, well, I'm not sure about that red dress. But you still wear it every single year.
Like
we have never seen it before.
So I'm going to try this without maple syrup first, just to see how it is.
Pancake.
Yeah, it tastes like pancakes and cream cheese. Not bad. Pretty basic, but then again, I'm a basic guy. Overall, just the design of it and the coloration alone, I love it. Very Grinch themed, very Christmas themed. But I know you're here for mainly the other two, so let's see what they think.
Okay, so I have the Martha May chicken and waffles. It's a chicken thigh with chicken waffles.
No problem, thank you.
And scrambled eggs, because I don't like fried eggs, so try the eggs first. Yeah, scrambled eggs, they're seasoned very well. Now let's get into this chicken with the hot honey and waffle, and it's not bad. It's a pretty standard breakfast. Like the chicken is moist, the hot honey definitely gives it a little extra. And it's a waffle, basic sweet cream waffle. Nothing to complain about, nothing to rave about.
I also got the Martha May chicken and waffles.
So he got it, and
I
should
did
be.
Get it with the fried egg on top, because I love a nice yolky, like, drip over chicken, because I love that little extra kind of thing there. So, start with, try and get a little bit of everything right here.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, you also have the modified to come with tater tots, correct?
I did ask for a side of tater tots, and they were nice enough to allow me. The thing that called to me personally on this was, this is a fried chicken thigh. I like dark meat better than white meat, personally. So that called to me. A lot of people, you know, like a fried chicken breast. I like a fried chicken thigh, personally, so get a little bit of a yolk on here, a little waffle. This is actually pretty good. The hot honey, not super spicy. It's more sweet than spicy, in my opinion.
I love the hot honey.
It's delicious. The waffle was a little dry, but the kind of sauce that goes over the top, I dipped it in the little bit of yolk from the egg, and it kind of moistened it up just a little bit. But overall, it's not bad. Could be a tiny bit hotter, but, you know, probably just laid it up over there, just waiting to come out to us. So can't blame them for that. But overall, I think it's delicious.
Oh, gingerbread cookies!
A gingerbread cookie.
Oh my goodness! Oh, I might have to get that!
And we got these cookies. These are good.
The Grinch made them himself.
They said there might be some onion in it, though, which, you know, just adds a little extra.
Yeah, just be a little careful. I tried to tell him not to put onions in it, but I don't know. He might have gone rogue with
it. I mean, he wants to put his own little touch on it, so.
It's like salted caramel, a little sweet, a little savory. You know,
It's better than fur.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. I made him wear gloves and a hairnet. Don't worry.
Good.
No fur in those cookies.
As long as you have presents under the tree and you have family with you, then it's all right now.
Perfect, yes.
We just finished meeting the Grinch for breakfast. And then we're going back later tonight to do the holiday tour to catch the show.
Great!
And then meet Grinch again, and we're going to meet Santa. So we can just tell him what we want for Christmas there, right?
It's
that's the same.
Yeah. Wonderful, and Max is an amazing dog.
Oh, that's my, I can't wait to meet Max.
Both. Sometimes they get into the hoo hash, but that's okay. We forgive him, we love him anyway.
It happens.
All right, so we just finished up with the Grinch breakfast. Overall, is it worth it? $57.99 is what it was for a standard ticket. Yes and no. Let's go over the whys it would not be worth it. If you're going for just the food, it's not worth it.
The food is like a scale 1 to 10. It's probably like a 6.
Very mediocre.
It suffices.
But the fact that you get to meet the Grinch and you don't have to wait in a 2 to 4 hour line, maybe even more than that some days, and you get interactions with all the Whos of Whoville,
yes,
who are all incredible. A special shout out to
Dora Decora.
Dora Decora, who was amazing. You will be getting a
Well, Snooty Who was fun too.
Snooty Who was fun too.
Sam Who.
Stew.
Stew Who, sorry.
No,
Sam I Am was there.
Yeah, that was another new thing.
You would pay way more than this at any other theme park for a character interaction,
yes,
like breakfast, lunch, or dinner. So $57 is less than I think I would have spent at Disney, and the actual face characters made it worth it for sure.
But yes, food, meh. Experience, thumbs up. So
and we
overall,
got
so, yes, and we got
yeah,
cookies.
These are like $6 a pack, and they're Grinch sugar cookies, and of course, Grinch made them with love, so they might have some onions in them, they said.
Oh boy. But anyway, overall, is it worth it? Yes.
Yes.
But that's going to do it for our time here at Islands of Adventure, because we're done with breakfast, so now it's time for the holiday tour. Not quite time for us yet. We got a few hours to go, but for you, it'll just be a few seconds. And we're back.
So we are officially at the holiday tour now. And
at
now,
Universal Studios, we
yeah,
are.
Well, we're kind of between parks right now.
Well, we're right outside what used to be Nickelodeon Studios,
then the
and
Blue
then
Man
it
Group.
Was the Blue Man Group, and now it's just a hub for various VIP events. So, if you do VIP tours, more than likely this is what you're going to see. Well, we're about to experience the Grinch show without having to wait for it.
The Grinchmas Hooliday Spectacular.
Yes, that particular show. Then we get to meet the man in green himself, the Grinch.
Again. So let's see if he remembers us. I mean,
yeah.
We also get to meet his faithful companion, Max, which personally
yes.
I'm excited for.
We get to meet the big man in the red suit himself, Santa Claus.
Apparently we get an attraction. We get some snacks
We
and
don't
drinks,
know what the attraction
cookies,
is.
Cookies.
We're hopeful that it's not Jimmy Fallon.
Well, I mean, it's going to be Fast and Furious, obviously. Why? We're going to do Fast and Furious. Why? Family. Got to meet our tour guide.
Yeah,
her name is Devin. She seems super
yeah.
sweet. Can't wait to see how she makes this tour her own. That's the great thing about these tours is each guide is different.
Yes.
So you're going to get a whole different experience every single time you do this.
Indeed.
And now, let's bring you on the adventure.
He cleaned out that icebox as quick as a flash. Why? That old Grinch even took their last can of hoo-ha.
Oh! Why is it on the mantle?
Then he stuffed all the presents up the chimney with glee.
And now,
grinned the Grinch,
I'm gonna step up a tree.
So the Grinch grabbed a tree and he started to shove when he heard a small sound like the whoop of a dove. He turned around fast and he saw a small who, little Cindy Lou Who.
Santa
But you know, that old Grinch was so smart and so slick. He thought up a lie and he thought it up quick.
Why, my sweet little pot.
The fake Santa Claus lied!
You're not helping!
All right.
Why, there's a light on this tree. That one light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, and I'll bring it back here. I'm rhyming again.
So we just got done with the Grinch Spectacular, and I have to say, that was one of the best shows we've seen, and we've done this 3 years in a row. I have to say, the person playing Martha Mayhew killed it. Voice of like an angel. Just, oh my gosh. There were some cool ad-libs. Max did not want to cooperate, so the Grinch was able to add in some quirky lines and everything, but amazing show. Easily a 8 out of 10, I would say. The show?
Eight
out of 10.
Max totally stole the show.
Oh yeah, Max.
Yeah. Barking at the end and Grinch telling him to shut up, basically.
Yeah, it was amazing. But on to our next, which is apparently a meet and greet with the big man himself. What are you going to ask for Christmas? Let us know in the comment section down below.
We wanted to get something to
whose primary idea was this?
Mine.
Yellow and blue and red for the primary colors, right?
They change color too, so this is like gold and silver and green and red.
Silver and gold.
Yes.
Silver and green and red. So we've got complementary colors too.
Yep. Yes. And then mine's just blue and silver.
Blue and silver.
Like, I guess Hanukkah.
Right. Okay, that's a good one, right? That one's starting Christmas Day this year.
Oh, wow.
Pretty excited about that, right? Yes. That's interesting, right? Sometimes they coincide
beforehand.
Let's
you get your job done
right.
First.
Right?
Yeah, I love Rugrats. Like, I'm right. A big Nickelodeon cartoon.
Oh, there it is.
So Rugrats celebrated every holiday.
You're like a coloring book.
So, yes. I've got to get a lot of those colored in to catch up to those.
Got to catch them all.
Got to catch them all, exactly.
Up, right?
Now, I know you always ask people, what do we want for Christmas? But what do you want for Christmas?
What do I want for Christmas?
Yes.
Thank you. Yes, yes. I do a lot of traveling during the holidays, so I always hope for safe travels, right? And so be able to have healthy friends and family also, right? And all those cookies!
Love it. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Wonderful.
Well, hello.
Look, it's one of those weird ones. It's one of those weird micro ones that makes me feel awkward in my workplace.
So how are you doing today?
I'm doing very good. How are you doing today?
Wishing that Christmas was being gotten done and over with.
You're ready for it to be done already?
Yeah.
It's not even Thanksgiving.
I'm not a Christmas.
You're taking over. Please, just let me tell you something. All right. I can already tell you're in the danger zone. All right. You keep this mood. You keep this up. You're gonna end up trying to steal Christmas, and then you're gonna get a reputation. And it's just so watch yourself. All right. That's all I'm saying. Just watch yourself.
I mean, I do like Halloween. So.
Halloween's a good holiday, but come on. Come on! It's the best holiday ever. Come on, give me a hug.
Okay.
Give me a hug.
Aww.
Let's take a photo together.
Yes.
Right?
Well, I hope you have a great Christmas or happy.
Have a good Christmas too.
Happy
whether you like
holidays.
It or not. Happy holidays.
Yes.
Happy holidays.
Yes.
I'll take it. Okay. You're good. Hello, Max.
Hello.
Hi, Max.
Oh, I agree. I'm sleepy too. It's been a long day.
You're a good boy.
Oh my gosh. You were making a lot of noise in the last show. It was amazing. You were just precious. You got your eyes on something. I think it's chicken nuggets. I like chicken nuggets too. What about Paul? You know Paul? No, oh, I know who he likes better.
He's not a
Slytherin. Well, hold on.
Good boy.
Change places.
Okay.
Can I have a Paul now? If you lift the other one, I'm gonna stick. Oh,
there you go.
Okay. I was gonna say if he shakes hands with the other Paul, I'm gonna just. Max, you know more tricks than my dog, and I love you. Oh. I love you, Max.
That's right.
Is that so? We'll tell the Grinch that.
Good boy.
Oh, boy.
Well, that was awesome.
That just made my life.
Yeah, we just met Max, who was adorable. Grabbed my hand twice.
I switched places, so he thought I was him, so he grabbed my hand.
And then he recognized, oh, wait, he's over here. So he grabbed him again.
And then he talked to us.
Yeah. That in itself is makes it worth it for this tour. I mean, that, meeting the Grinch, meeting Santa. So we've done all of our meet and greets. So what's left? Well, we have desserts still to go. And, of course, we have a ride somewhere. We don't know what.
We've got decorations, of course.
Decorations. And, of course, we are going to make our way over to Hogwarts and see what's going on at the castle.
Can't forget the tribute store either.
Oh, yeah,
we haven't seen the holiday tribute store yet this year.
Gotta go see Earl the Squirrel.
Earl the Squirrel has a book, and apparently he's publicizing it, so we gotta go learn the story of Earl the Squirrel and how he became such a famous celebrity here at Universal Studios Florida.
Yeah, well, we're running out of battery, so let's move on.
Okay, microphone's not wanting to connect, but we are here in front of the beautiful Christmas tree. You said total height is 80 feet?
80 feet tall.
Imagine,
8 foot star, 72 foot tree.
Imagine trying to put this together.
No, thank you.
No. But one thing that they always do is they hide Earl the Squirrel. So we're going to see if we can find him. Because thankfully, I did not hear where you said it was. So we're going to go try and find him. So let's go.
Tell him hot or cold, okay?
Well, so it's not where I thought it was.
Oh, okay. But did you see it?
I did see it.
Okay.
Yeah!
Are we getting hotter or are we getting colder?
Oh, right there. Right there.
He's right there.
Good luck. Okay, I don't know. All right.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Well, that was easy. Hi, Earl.
This is Squirrel.
And he has a little ornament. Oh, no.
Is that Earl or is that his girlfriend?
That's
Some
Earl.
Would say that Earl likes to have a shocking Christmas.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
So?
Yeah.
You have to read the instructions.
Look for these colored shapes throughout the store for fun ways to interact. Square touch, hexagon listen, green circle smell, blue triangle play, yellow star taste.
I ain't tasting nothing.
Play?
Smell?
No, I think it's, I don't know. No, you'll see it. That's not.
Scratch
and smell. Does it smell like pine
trees? Oh, it does.
Smells like pine.
Nice.
There's another one. Oh no.
Oh, that's. Yeah. I think that's mint.
I don't believe I'm going to be sniffing that one. I will happily allow one of you two.
No, it's not mint.
What is it?
It smells like wall. But
what?
It smells like wall.
It
smells like a wall.
It's fur.
This is touch. Where's your touch?
It's like fur.
Oh.
Oh.
So square.
Oh. Touch.
Oh, nice.
Soft.
So soft.
Okay, so there's no like things to tell us. I don't get any smell.
Let's see if
nothing.
Yeah, I just smell wall.
But you know, you go that Grinch is so slick, he taught up a lie, thought it real quick. There's got to be something.
Watch, we're going to be playing back the video and seeing exactly what the circle is and knowing that we're doing it all wrong.
Gosh, I like this one better.
I wish more people were fluent and silent.
That's open. So you can't even read it before you buy it.
Yes, you can. It's on the wall.
Is it the whole thing throughout?
Probably.
So show the camera.
It's $15.99 for the Tale of Earl the Squirrel.
But no discount.
No discount.
No annual pass. No visa.
I think I'm good. Oh, and also, if you notice, there's a little hole here. See? Earl will come out every now and again.
Oh, there he is. Hey, Earl.
So one thing that I personally love about the history of this park is they hide things inside the garland to do dedications to like previous rides and attractions that were here. So it's a little hard to see right now because we're a little far away from it and it's dark, but like right next to the Born Spectacular, they actually have a metal skull inside of one of the wreaths. And it's a very small skull, probably about this big, hidden in it. And what's great about that is, for those of you who know about the history of Universal Studios, the Born Spectacular used to be the Terminator 2 3D battle across time.
So you seamlessly travel back in time with the Terminator. So in that building, that attraction used to be in the metal skulls in the wreath, it's a dedication to it.
Up the holiday tour. Special shout out to our tour guide, Devin. You were amazing. Definitely, if you're ever coming out here, request Devin. She is, like I said, just amazing. She has so much knowledge, and let's just say, she gives the tour a whole lot better than some of the other tour guides we've met.
But, on the whole, is it worth the money? Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Three yeses.
Three yeses. Three unanimous yeses. Now let me say this. If you only have the choice between the Grinch breakfast and the holiday tour, do the holiday tour.
Yeah. Grinch breakfast is only like maybe 2 hours at max, or this is 5 hours of just pure fun.
Yes.
I mean, you get to do the show. You get to meet Santa, meet the Grinch, meet Max. Just like...
have some... wonderful appetizers and desserts.
Yep. The desserts were delicious.
They were.
Like, for me,
I was
personally,
very surprised
like,
by eggnog cheesecake. Yeah, I usually am not a fan of eggnog. Oh, 7%.
The what? Foods and everything, the service, the...
everything was spot on tonight.
Being in a crowd, being in a group of like maybe 200, 300 people tops in the entire Hogsmeade Village was really cool.
Yes.
But overall...
and being in the very front... of
yes.
that.
Yes.
Thanks to Devin for getting us the first group there.
Yes.
Devin, got some amazing pictures and videos.
Amazing.
But other than that, our night is slowly coming to an end. So
and we are tired.
Yes, my back is killing me. So
mine too.
As always, I'm Daniel.
I'm Matthew.
And I'm Mikey.
And we are A to Z Thrills. And say it with us now. Keep calm and coaster on.
Good night,
guys.
Bye, guys.